Shalom Rastafari, I am Alon Kone Tafari, and there's an issue, a big issue regarding bullying in America. And you know, America being mystery Babylon, everything's such a big mystery. No one knows what's going on and how this came to be and what can be done. Well, I'm here to shine some light based on the teachings of His Imperial Majesty on how these issues, I mean, the answer to these problems we're confronted with today have been answered yesterday. And we're going to be discussing this issue. Now, the documentary released on bullies, or bully, that kind of, I guess, put this whole conversation out there, is this young man who committed suicide because he just could not take the pressures of the system anymore. He couldn't take pressure from the peers and being bullied, you know, played around with. Now, I'm addressing this issue not only because it's critical and crucial. Our God and Father, Haile Selassie, clearly addressed this problem some years back. And I thought it was important because what I saw on while investigating this issue was sad, really sad. And this is out for the parents and especially the parents that don't know what to do regarding their kids being punked around and school officials doing nothing about it. I want to let you know that through our God and Father, Haile Selassie, and His Christ, Jesus, I hope to shine some light upon you parents struggling out there, because these questions have been answered. And I want to make it quite clear that the media is not going to do anything about it. They're giving you this false hope. This I can see right through this. It's a money-making machine, you know, like, they're giving you this false idea that because of this documentary, now steps are going to be taken to actually solve this issue, and there's being more attention being paid to this. It's a bunch of lies, and they're actually, Hollywood has run out of ways to take your money regarding movies. I mean, they're duplicating everything that's ever been done, because they have no ideas, they have no origination. And so, this, I strongly believe, is an attempt to use real situations and your pity to produce large incomes of money, because this is really happening. Bullying is a big thing throughout the world. It's a big issue, and it's been a big issue since our God and Father declared it to be an issue. Long before, you know, this documentary or whatever, since 1936 it was declared at Geneva, Switzerland. Now, the parents of this young man made an appearance on the Ellen DeGeneres show. I don't care about Ellen. I'm sure she's a wonderful person. I'm not here to I'm not here to disrespect nobody, but what I am here to say is it's incredible what people do, the lengths people go to make some money. Now, the parents came on the show and they spoke about this young gentleman that committed suicide for, like, what, a brief 1 minute? And then all of a sudden, the whole momentum shifted to, but let's talk about the light of the situation, the only good that came from this. And so the parents start saying that in a time of darkness where everything was like being numb or numbness and or, you know, sad, grief because of the loss of their child, right? But that it was like the dawning of a new day, because at 4 o'clock, 4 o'clock became this monument time, like during the day where every day, and these are the parents speaking, that if it wasn't for 4 o'clock in the afternoon, they do not know what they would have done. But the parents are declaring how important 4 o'clock was to them and what it meant to them. Why? Because at 4 o'clock, the Ellen show was on. And so these parents, you know, they lost their child, and finally, every day at 4, they could enjoy an hour of happiness and laughter and enjoyment. And come on, that was sad. What do people do for money? Honestly, I'm not a parent, but I would not be saying those things, you know. You lost your son's dead, but you know, like, who cares? Because at 4 o'clock, the Ellen show is on, and that makes everything better. So that right there, take it in consideration. These people are messing around with you. They're making money off of your pity, off of your suffering, and it's time to wake up, pretty much. Now, let's begin addressing this issue. So stop bullying and speak up. Stand up for your right, you know? Some people think that Almighty God is going to come from the sky, you know, and take away all your problems and make everyone feel high, you know? But Haile Selassie say that, you know, Bob Marley, Robert Nesta. And so, no, let's stand up. We got to stand up. We got to go from being dumbasses, and this is a take note for all, including I, that seek discipline and to disciple in the line of Judah society, and therefore we do studies and, you know, confront certain issues regarding, well, everything, because the earth is the dominion of our Father, so everything is, we study everything, basically. So now, it's take note that, what does dumb mean? Dumb means that you're silent, you can't speak, not able to speak, to talk. What is an ass? An ass is a domesticated horse, like a house servant, a house slave. So a dumbass is a house slave that keeps quiet. This is all in the book of Numbers, chapter 22. Now, it's time for I and I to be smartasses. Because when you're in class and you say something intelligent that actually shines light upon the actual study, you're referred to as a smartass because you spoke. So in the case of, in the story of Balaam and situation where the angel of the Lord is he's in the narrow way and he's got his sword in hand, and if it wasn't for that ass saving Balaam's ass and being a smart ass, because Jah caused that ass to speak, to stand up and speak for, you know, like, and I got lost big time. Now give me just 1 second to get back on track. So basically, let us just speak up. I mean, it says it pretty clear right there. I just wanted to include the ass scenario because of what our brother Yadon had mentioned regarding Obama calling this other artist, Kanye West, I believe, jackass, because Jackass is a stubborn house servant. And so you guys can go and do some more study on that. And how an ass carries all the weight of him who's riding on him. And he's the beast of burden. And so if we recall Book of Numbers chapter 22, when Jah causes the ass to speak, he tells Balaam, like, have I not always been there for you? Have I not always let you rode on my back? Have I not carried your weight? You know, like, I would never smite you 3 times the way you did. And then the angel of the Lord says, well, this ass saved your ass, Balaam. If it wasn't for this ass, I would have I would have knocked you out like long ago. So this is important to note because the house of Israel, the real Hebrew Israelites have been through a whole lot more than bullying. And they have been that beast of burden in the, not that Israel is a beast, but they've carried all the weight of the United States. And I don't hear no complaining. So it's time to stand up, speak up, you know, and we gotta be smart asses and not wanna be slaves in the house, rather not be slaves at all. It's important to take this in consideration, you know, like, I mean, I don't want to bring the race issue or anything because it's, because I don't think we should be looking at things that way anymore. But just to make a point, the young child that committed suicide was Caucasian, you could say. And there's a documentary out on it, and you know, parents are speaking up or whatever, and look at what the House of Israel have been through, and little, if any, attention is ever paid to that. So I'm highly disgusted by that. So let's just continue, because that's an endless topic. Now, here's an image of, it's an Ethiopic illuminated scroll. The angel of the Lord with the sword on his hand, and Balaam smiting the ass, and the ass turning back and saying, "Look, man, have I ever done anything like this to you?" So, now, bullying. The definition of bullying is assault or coercion, and may be directed repeatedly towards particular victims, perhaps on the grounds of race, religion, gender, sexuality, or ability. The imbalance of power may be social power and or physical power. The victim of bullying is sometimes referred to as a target, right? Now we're gonna, this has commenced the actual answer to this whole bullying issue. The target, in this case, Ethiopia, Holy Imperial Ethiopia. This is where the connection is made to Rastafari and how His Majesty declared this soon to come bullying problem. Now, excuse me. Now, this is a bully, Benito Mussolini, that thought he could, because of more advanced military, I guess, weaponry and more, a better economy or whatever, Italy decided to invade Ethiopia. For no reason, unjustly. So this is the beginning of bullying. And His Imperial Majesty, after fighting, his counselors suggested it was best for him to plead for the nation and to leave the country, because if our father Haile Selassie were to be captured, then that would mean, or killed, that would have meant the end of any hope, any opportunity of success. And now I'm gonna read a small section of the speech, that famous speech where he prophesied, or not prophesy, just he spoke truth. He said what was going to, was, he laid it out straight, you know. the fact that nobody wanted to listen, it makes it seem like prophecy. He just spoke truth. Truth will stand the test of time. So no matter what it is, when you speak truth, it will come to be. Whether in a couple of days, in a few weeks, in years, even in a century, who cares? But it will come to be. Therefore, it will later be recognized as prophecy. So, the leak threatened. This is only a small section of the actual speech. It is collective security. It is the very existence of the League of Nations. It is the confidence that each state is to place in international treaties. It is a value of promises made to small states that their integrity and their independence shall be respected and ensured. It is the principle of the equality of states on the one hand, or otherwise the obligation laid upon small powers to accept bonds of vassalship. In a word, it is international morality that is at stake. Have the signatures appended to a treaty value only in so far as the signatory powers have a personal, direct, and immediate interest involved? No subtlety can change the problem or shift the grounds of the discussion. It is in all sincerity that I submit these considerations to the Assembly at a time when my people are threatened with extermination, when the support of the League may ward off the final blow. May I be allowed to speak with complete frankness, without resistance, in all directness, such as is demanded by the rule of equality as between all states, members of the League. Apart from the kingdom of Jah, Rastafari, there is not on this earth any nation that is superior to any other. Should it happen that a strong government finds it may with impunity destroy a weak people, then the hour strikes for that weak people to appeal to the League of Nations to give its judgment in all freedom. God and history will remember your judgment. Me today, you tomorrow. That's not part of it, but His Imperial Majesty is clearly showing the way. We are to, until we are able and willing to stand up and die for truth, we will never live. We would have never have lived. It's that time to be smartasses. Speak up. Luckily, our God and Father waited patiently on the right hand of our Lord Adonai, and until enemies had been made thy footstool, and with patience, courage, faith, just cause, inevitably David will always beat Goliath. So in this situation, it did not result in suicide. The lion was unconquerable, overcoming death. But ultimately, this is the beginning of this issue, of this modern issue regarding bullying. Now, to discuss the answers, we're going to have to go forward in time to 1963, where is on October the 6th, His Imperial Majesty answered a lot of questions, as a matter of fact. And this speech given by Haile Selassie, King of Kings, Elect of God, Conquering Lion of the Tribe of Judah, Emperor of Ethiopia. Now, Mr. President, distinguished delegates, 27 years ago, as Emperor of Ethiopia, I mounted a rostrum in Geneva, Switzerland, to address to the League of Nations an appeal for relief from the destruction which had been unleashed against my defenseless nation by the fascist invader. I spoke then, both to and for the conscience of the world. My words went unheeded, but history testifies to the accuracy of the warning that I gave in 1936. Today I stand before the world, organization which has succeeded to remantle, discarded by its discredited predecessor. This is speaking on the League of Nations, and this is the later to be United Nations. And its body is enshrined the principle of collective security, which is unsuccessfully invoked at Geneva. Here, in this assembly, reposes the best, perhaps the last hope for the peaceful survival of mankind. In 1936, I declare that it wasn't the covenant of the League that was at stake, but international morality. And the takings I said then have little worth of the will to keep them is lacking. Let me read that again, I apologize. I declared that it wasn't the covenant of the League that was at stake, but international morality, and the takings I said then have little worth if the will to keep them is lacking. The chart of the United Nations expresses the noblest desperations of man, the application of force in the settlement of dispute between states, the assurance of human rights and fundamental freedoms for all without distinction as to race, sex, language, or religion, the safeguarding of international peace and security. But these two, as were the phrases of the covenant, are only words that its value depends wholly on our will to observe and honor them and give them content and meaning. Just one second, please. Just to conclude, I'm going to read a couple of small sections of the speech given by His Imperial Majesty to the United Nations on October 6, 1963. It's very important that we all go into more into in depth regarding this brilliant work of His Imperial Majesty. Now, I'm just going to include a couple sections that will address the nowadays, the recent or present problems confronting America and the whole world, basically, regarding bullying. Now, the preservation of peace and governing of man's basic freedoms and rights require courage and eternal vigilance. Courage to speak and act, and if necessary, to suffer and die for truth and justice. Eternal vigilance that the least transgression of international morality should not go undetected and unremedied. Those small, undetected failures, or, well, transgressions of law, result in these more extreme situations. So take note. Now, secondly, on the question of racial discrimination, the Addis Ababa conference thought to those who will learn this further lesson, that until the philosophy that holds one race superior and another inferior is finally and permanently discredited and abandoned, until there are no longer first-class and second-class citizens of any nature, that until the color of a man's skin is of no more significance than the color of his eyes, that until the basic human rights are equally guaranteed to all without regard to race, that until that day, the dream of lasting peace, world citizenship, and the rule of international morality would remain but a fleeting illusion to be pursued but never obtained. I'll conclude there. Because the rest is actually addressing another issue. Well, same. It speaks on the freedom of Angola and Mozambique and so on and so forth. So there you go. That's basically the answer. Why do kids hit other kids? Because they're bigger and they think they can. Until we address every single issue, stand up for every single issue where we force that this world maintain an equality, disregarding size, weight, sex, religion, gender, whatever, you name it. So this, America, this problem of your kids being abused is the same issue that His Imperial Majesty addressed in 1936 at Geneva, Switzerland.